Good morning students, I welcome you all in this beautiful session. Today I am here with the topic the tenses part 2. As earlier we have studied and we come to know that tense is time sense. The word came from tempus. It tells us about the action takes place at what time. Tenses are of three types, present, past and future. The action is done in present time or before or it is going to be happen next. Today we will discuss about the past tense. As we have studied in the present tense that it has been categorized in four different parts. Similarly, the past tense also has divided into four. Past indefinite tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. Let's know more about past tense. It refers to a verb tense that expresses actions or states in the past. It is a verb form that shows action that has already taken place. Let's know more about it. Why do we use past tense verbs? So, to tell that an action is completed, finished or over. At what time? In the past, somewhere. How? Means maybe we can say it happened already last week, long ago, yesterday or once upon a time or it may completed recently. It may got finished recently. Let's know more about it. Past simple or past indefinite tense. Look at the structure. Subject, second form of the verb and object. For example, I wrote a letter to my father. I is subject. Wrote, second form of the verb of write. A letter to my father, its object with extension. Look at the second example. She played badminton yesterday. She, subject, played, second form of the verb play. Badminton, object and yesterday is an extension. Now see the structure for the sentence in past tense when we want to make it negative. As you know, we have used here the second form of the verb. So, for making it negative, we need to convert it once again in the first form of the verb with the helping verb did not. Subject plus helping verb did not plus first form of the verb and object. We did not attend the dance class. My teacher did not punish me. Here you need to see with the use of did not, we use main verb in the first form. Sometimes it's a very common mistake done by the students that while making any of the past simple tense sentence in negative form, they usually forget to change the form of the verb from second to first. You should remember when you are going to make negative sentence with the past simple tense, you need to put did, not and then first form of the verb. Like if you said I wrote a letter to my father, then what will be the negative sentence? I did not write a letter to my father. She played badminton yesterday. She did not play badminton yesterday. So wrote converted into write and played changed into play. For making interrogative sentence, what we need to do? Remember, we always put helping verb before the subject. So here, what's the helping verb? For present simple tense, helping verb is did. So what will be the structure? The structure will be, did Karan eat a slice of pizza? So to change into interrogative sentence, we use helping verb did before the subject. Did you love my magic show? And don't forget to put question mark. With did, use always the first form of the verb, like we have seen in negative sentences. Let's move further. Past continuous tense. The tense is used to describe an action or activity going on at some time in the past. Once again, you should pay attention. Going on at some time in the past. If you want to say that I was doing something in past, then and the action was going on, it was in progress. So for making progressive sentence in the past, we will use past continuous tense. I was speaking to my younger brother. The boys were going to school. Look at the structure. Past continuous tense, subject, was or were, it's the past form of be. Was and were with first form of verb with ing. She was cooking all morning. She, subject, was, past form of be, and cooking, cook is the first form of the verb with ing. For making it negative, very simple, after putting was or were, we need to put not. So subject, was or were, not, and first form of the verb with ing. She was not sleeping when he came home. Look at the interrogative sentence. The structure is very simple. Put helping verb before the subject, was or were, plus subject, then first form of the verb with ing, end the sentence with question mark. Was she sleeping when he came home? Question mark. Uses and examples of past perfect tense. Now see, action finished before another past action. Like Richard had gone out when his wife arrived in the office. Action happened before a specific time in the past. Christian had never been to an opera before last night. Action started in the past and continued up to a given time in the past. We had owned that car for 10 years before it broke down. Now see the structure. Past perfect tense. Always remember, here we are going to use the past form of the verb have. It become had here. So subject, had, and past participle form of the verb means the third form of the verb. She had finished the test. For negative, she had not finished the test. And for interrogative, had she finished the test? And end with question mark. Look at the past perfect continuous tense. She had plus been plus first form of verb with ing. They had been playing tennis. They had not been playing tennis. Had they been playing tennis? And then question mark. Now look at the uses and more examples of past perfect continuous tense. So past perfect continuous tense is used to describe a past action already started and continued up to another action or time in the past. Here we need to mention the time. To express the duration before something in the past, when the action was going on for with time, duration. To describe the cause of something in the past. Now move to the examples. The boys had been playing soccer for about an hour when it started to rain. Richard needed a holiday because He had been working hard for 6 months. Here, reason. And with the duration of time. He was tired because he had been jogging. Now here, if you are not putting any time, then also okay. I hope you understand the past tense with all its four categories, their uses and their examples. Thank you.